Welcome to the Viral Academy. Today we are focusing on an important topic, namely exhaust gas after treatment, more specifically NOx treatment and how this is measured. I have brought along an article about this. This is a NOx sensor and we will now take a closer look at how it works. Exhaust gas after treatment is also an issue in this vehicle and is of great importance. We have installed an SCR catalytic converter that works with AdBlue. Everyone has heard of this before. The function is such that the nitrogen oxides produced during the combustion process are converted into water and nitrogen using urea. These end products are not harmful. To ensure that this works and that we add the right amount of AdBlue, we have installed a NOx sensor that can then measure exactly how much nitrogen oxide is now reaching the SCR catalytic converter. For the exact function of such a NOx sensor, let's take a brief theoretical look at the structure. Here we have a graphic representation of a sensor. Here, the exhaust gases hit a diffusion layer consisting of nitrogen oxides and oxygen. Oxygen is dissipated via a solid electrolyte to which a voltage is applied. What remains is nitrogen oxide. This hits the next diffusion layer and then an electrode. This electrode has the property of splitting the nitrogen oxides into nitrogen and oxygen. If we remove the oxygen using another solid electrolyte, we can use the required current to determine how much nitrogen oxide has initially entered the probe.
Des benötigten Stroms dafür ermitteln, wie viel Stickoxide am Anfang in die Sonne gekommen sind. Die Funktion hätten wir jetzt soweit geklärt. Jetzt ist noch die Frage, woher merke ich das?
How do I know if the component is defective? If the AdBlue system is no longer working, the vehicle will no longer start or will go into emergency mode and, of course, the engine control light will come on. This is easy for workshops to diagnose. We check our sensors carefully to ensure that they are working properly. To do this, we now take a trip to our quality management department. It can happen that quickly. We are now here in our quality management department and my colleague Victor is showing me how we can carry out the test on our NOx sensors with this device. We start by selecting the test protocol that matches the component. Our device recognizes this automatically. It now automatically sees which sensor is connected here? Exactly. I see. After a short search, a suitable test protocol has been identified. Now let's run the test. How long does a run take? The test should be at least 5 minutes long in order to check the load on the sensor properly. This is probably because the sensor also has to be brought to a certain temperature so that the process can be tested sufficiently, right? Exactly, that's right. The test is over and the sensor has passed. Perfect. Then we can now install the new sensor on the vehicle. So back to the workshop. As we are here with the NOx sensor upstream of the diesel particulate filter, we still have a lot of particles that settle in the sensor, which can also lead to failure. Now we install the new sensor. We have now installed the sensor properly. Of course, we make sure that the cable sits properly in the guide again so that no fire can occur due to heat. Now we reinstall the air filter box on the battery and then we have to check again with the diagnostic device. Here we take another look at the fault memory to make sure that the new NOx sensor has been recognized in the vehicle. There is only one error code stored here because of the steering angle sensor, but this is resolved during the test drive. The test drive was great. No error occurred. So the vehicle is ready for use again. If you liked the video, give us a thumbs up. If you have any questions or suggestions, leave us a comment. See you next time.